What's going on, everybody? It's Sasha, your real estate market expert here in Charlotte. I hope you all are doing well and welcome back to the channel, where today we're going to be talking about the seven things you should know before moving right here to Charlotte. If you haven't already, hit that subscribe button, hit the like button, and leave a comment if you have any questions. But as you already know by now, if you've watched some of my other videos, you can always call, text, or email me anytime. I'm always available for you. With that being said, let's get started with the first thing you should know. So the first thing you should know is that Charlotte's geographical location is great, especially if you like traveling and like exploring other areas. If you want to go to the mountains, you can go up to Asheville. If you want to go skiing in the wintertime, you can go up to Boone, and both of those are just under 2.5 hours. So even though we are landlocked, we still have a bunch of lakes here near Charlotte. The predominant ones are going to be Lake Norman and Lake Wylie. So if you have a boat, if you want to go jet skiing, tubing, paddle boarding, kayaking, any of that, you can always do that. If you wanted to go to the beach, if you wanted to be near the ocean, you can go to Myrtle Beach, South Carolina, Charleston, South Carolina, Wilmington, North Carolina, which are all under 3.5 hours away. You can also go down to Atlanta if you wanted to. There's actually some really fun islands over there in Georgia as well that are about a 5-hour drive. And if you wanted to go to the Smoky Mountains in Tennessee, that's just a 4-hour drive. And my fiance and I actually met a whole bunch of friends from Ohio in the Smoky Mountains a couple months ago, rented a big cabin, had a blast, and that was only a 4-hour drive. Not to mention, we have one of the best airports in the nation. So if you find yourself traveling a lot or you do go overseas, we have a ton of direct flights, which are extremely convenient for you, so you're not having to do multiple layovers in different cities and adding on that extra time onto your trip. Before I forget, a question a ton of people ask me is about hurricanes and does Charlotte get affected by hurricanes? And with us being so far inland, we're 2 to 2.5 hours away from the coast, so we're not that affected by it. We do get the rain, we do get the winds and things like that, but honestly, it's not a major concern for us here. The second thing you should know is that Charlotte's cost of living is slightly below the national average for now. I don't think that's going to be the case in the next 10 to 15 years, but as of right now, the cost of living is below the national average. So depending on where you're actually moving from, you could be saving some money or you could be spending a little bit more money on your cost of living. Me, for example, coming from Cleveland, Ohio, where the cost of living was really cheap, coming down here, it was more expensive, but to me, it was 100% worth it. If you'd like to learn a little bit more about the cost of living in Charlotte, check out my other video that I made. I'm gonna link it up here, and I'm also gonna put it down in the description box. It goes a little bit more in depth about the cost of living here. To be honest, I'm extremely embarrassed about that video. It was one of the first ones I did, but from what people tell me, it's still, I did a really good job of explaining everything and people found it useful, so make sure to check it out. So this brings me to the third thing you should know about Charlotte is we're positioned for great economical growth. We're still a newer city, but we still have a lot of room for that growth and for all those people that are moving here. We're expanding roadways, transit systems, and there's still a lot of land left undeveloped. There's still a ton of cranes in Uptown, and all that stuff is gonna keep moving and keep developing, but the surrounding area, we still have a tremendous amount of room to grow even more. And a lot of big companies are starting to notice. In North Carolina, we have 13 Fortune 500 companies, and 7 of those are located in Charlotte. One of them is located in Mooresville. If you don't know about Mooresville, it's located just north of Charlotte. Awesome suburb, you should definitely check it out. But as you can see, there's 8 Fortune 500 companies in the Charlotte metro area alone. And we all know that the tech industry is huge and it keeps growing. And Charlotte was actually just ranked the #1 tech town in America based off of cost of living, number of tech positions available, and the projected growth we're expected to have in the next 12 months to 5 years. The fourth thing you should know is that if you like a big city with a small town feel, Charlotte is it. If you like the hustle and bustle of the city, you can have all that in Uptown, but as soon as you get out of Uptown, there's so many beautiful, charming neighborhoods, tree-lined streets, beautiful houses, that you totally forget how close you are to the city. And if you want to live in a rural area, then if you want to raise cows, chickens, horses, anything like that, you can get that as well, just 30 to 45 minute drive just from uptown Charlotte. The fifth thing you should know is that Charlotte is great for sports fans. Don't ask me about championships, Super Bowls, any of that stuff. I like sports because of the community, the environment, and the way that it brings people together. So no matter what season of the year it is, there's something going on. We have the Charlotte Hornets for basketball, Carolina Panthers, which is like a religion here, which is our football team. We have a Major League Soccer team that's expected to start playing in 2022. We have a minor league hockey team, the Charlotte Checkers. We have a minor league baseball team, which the stadium's awesome. I love going there, buy a bunch of beer, have a good time. And also, I can't believe I forgot this in one of my other videos, which is NASCAR. If you haven't been to a NASCAR race or don't know the scoring or whatever, how it works, just go to a NASCAR race. Tickets are fairly cheap. Being in that environment and having a good time, tailgating is awesome. The stadium literally shakes. You have to wear earbuds and all that stuff, but it's a super fun time and it's definitely something you want to experience. The sixth thing you should know is that our Lynx Blue Line, which is our light rail transit system, is awesome, but you're most likely going to need a car unless you live fairly close to the light rail where you can go to work, go shopping, and all that other stuff. We are doing a really good job, like I said before, with the infrastructure, and they have just proposed and agreed upon extending the transit system. So within the next 10 years, it's gonna be available to a lot more people. And when it is, that might be a little bit different story, but for now, you're most likely gonna need a car to get around unless you live close by to the light rail. Number seven, Southern hospitality is still alive and well here in Charlotte. Now listen, it's not all sunshine and rainbows here, but for the majority of the people, they are extremely nice, nice enough to where you'll notice the difference depending on where you're coming from. Me coming from Ohio, when I came down here, I just thought it was so strange with all the people conversing with me at grocery stores, giving me compliments, neighbors waving at me. That was something new to me unless I know the person. So coming down here, I definitely noticed that Southern charm that people talk about, and it is still alive and well here in Charlotte. With all that being said, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If there's anything I can do for you, any questions I can answer for you, call, text, or email me anytime, and I'll catch you on the next one. Take care. Bye.